Good evening everybody, and welcome to my latest model train review video. Tonight I'm going to review the Tomix JR Series 700 Hikari Railstar, which is the Sanyo Shinkansen. The reason why I've chosen to review this model train pack is because I now have over 700 subscribers, and as a token of my appreciation and thanks, I've chosen this particular train to thank you all for subscribing to my channel. The reference number of the Tomix Shinkansen is 92751. And like with most Japanese train packs from Tomix, you get an outer sleeve and the models of this train pack actually comes in a plastic book type case. So if you have a large bookshelf, these are ideal to store in like rows for easy storage. You've also got the writing in English and in Japanese down here as well. And I would like to point out that all Tomix trains, as far as I know, are actually made in Japan as well. And when they're running on the tracks, the motors are relatively quiet. Or at least this one is anyway. So, upon removing the two clips, I'll just place the case on the desk. It just simply opens up like a book, quite literally, which also reveals the registration card and the instructions in this polythene packet, and a safety notice, which is all written in Japanese, on how not to use the model, and I'm assuming, like you get with most UK trains, probably it says something about the model's not suitable for younger users due to small parts, which in N-gauge it's understandable. So let's pop the instructions and the safety notice to one side. Let's have a look at the contents of the box, which is the JR Series 700 Hikari Railstar Shinkansen, which operates on the Sanyo lines in Japan. Excuse me. You get two driving trailers, which is this one, and if I just move the box into view, the second one's down here, and both have directional lighting, which is there, and pickups on both trucks to power the lights. Also, this one is actually based on the green car, as the interior is green, is painted green, as where on this carriage right down to the last driving trailer are in standard blue. So one would assume that the rest of these carriages would be standard class or something equivalent to that anyway. Right, we just have a look at the model in general. What you do also get is flush glazing throughout the model, complete with a corridor which actually flexes to left and right. So, and also on the roof, you've got a catenary or an aerodynamic fin on the top of the train as well. So I've just put that back in the box. There is some footage on my channel of this Hikari Railstar running, both on my layout and on the Kato viaduct track when I first bought this train pack in 2009. But this is the motored car. It's quite weighty. It's got all-wheel drive. If I just turn it round, you've got a worm drive going to this truck here, and you've also got a worm drive going to this truck as well, complete with the one-way style coupling system, as the coupling on this end has like a hook type pin, which on the driving trailer has a loop type socket coupler which this pin slots into. So all in all, this train only couples together in a certain way, but I do like that idea from Tomix, as it allows you to couple the train correctly and in the prototypical fashion. The pantograph also raises and lowers, but it's quite fiddly to dig out. I'd need a flat nose screwdriver to lift it out, but I'll show you that raised and lowered on the other trailer, as that one isn't so fiddly to rise. This one is also the green car variant, as the interior moulded seats on this motor coach is actually green. So let's move on to the third carriage you get in the set. Unfortunately, my battery warning light has just come on my camera, so I hope the battery lasts until I complete this review, but if not, I'll have to stop the video mid-flow and charge the battery up and then resume. But here is the third car. Again, this is the green car version, and the door formation is quite different, as the doors are here rather than on the ends, or the edges should I say. Flush glazing throughout, complete with the green car interior, and nice detail on the trucks as well. Not really much to cover on the carriages, as they tend to be a bit repetitive if you get more than just one variant in the train pack. But this is the standard class carriage, and this has the 3x2 seating. As in the green cars, I believe it's 2x2 seating. The doors are on the ends of this car, and the interior is actually blue. You've also got the catenary ceramic sort of joiner, which allows the rail company to extend, or in this case, shorten the JR700 train sets, as the Nozomi Shinkansens actually run in 16 car formations, including the new N700s. But likewise, you've got the one-way coupling system, and you've got like the blue interior complete with flush glazing as well. Although I will point out, there's no glazing on the end doors. This is because of the flexible corridor ends on each end of the carriage. Right, that's the fourth car sorted. Let's have a look at the fifth carriage. Just like with the fourth, this one is slightly different, as you've got Railstar on this end with the passenger door more positioned above the truck, as where on this end it's right on the end of the carriage. Although this has flush glazing on this door, there's no flush glazing on this door because of the flexible corridor end. But still, nicely detailed, and I think that covers the fifth carriage. Let's move on to the sixth one, and then we should be up to the second pantograph carriage. This is a standard class carriage, complete with a smoking room, as outlined by this metal framed window here. I'm not sure if the camera can pick that up, but this is actually the smoking room, as the Shinkansens in Japan do have smoking rooms for passengers that smoke. Also, as the doors are on the ends of the carriage rather than towards the middle where the trucks are, only the saloon windows are flush glazed, as there's no room to fit glazing on the carriage door windows because of the flexible corridor things on the ends. But that's the sixth carriage covered on this train pack. Let's have a look at the seventh carriage, and then we'll be on to the final carriage, which is the second driving trailer. Again, you've got another door there, complete with the Railstar logo, and you've got another door here, which is glazed, along with flush glazing across the carriage body. And you've also got a larger, I'm assuming this would be for disabled access or something like that, a larger passenger door here. And you've also got another window there. I'm not sure if that's another smoking room or whether this would be something like a buffet car or an onboard shop or something like that. But the pantograph on this carriage does actually raise, but it doesn't raise too high, because like with the actual Shinkansens, the pantographs are raised in quite a low position to reduce dynamic drag when the train's in motion. But likewise, it does rise and it does lower. The other one also raises and lowers, but it's quite stiff to adjust. This is also a standard class, as it's got the blue interior as well. So let's just pop that back in the box and let's move on to the second driving trailer, and also the final component of the JR700 Hikari Railstar Shinkansen, which is the JR West Shinkansen. Unlike with the first driving trailer, you've actually got the passenger door more towards the end of the unit, but like with the others, it's not glazed, but the rest of the windows on this driving unit, along with this second passenger door near the driver's cab, this is also glazed as well. You've got the Railstar logo there, and you've got the head and tail lights which operate in direction of travel on the front, complete with a basic detailed driver's cab and the surround windows. Right, that concludes my review of the Tomix JR Series 700 Hikari Railstar Shinkansen train. My overall rating score for this train pack, as I really do like it and I'm a fan of the JR Series 700, I'm going to give this a perfect 10 out of 10. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below, and thank you for watching. Stay tuned for another video coming soon.